Okay, in this chapter we would be discussing about facility layout. In this particular chapter we will be talking about what do we mean by facility layout and what are the objectives of facility layout, as well as we'll look into the various factors which affect facility layout and the various types of layout along with the advantages and disadvantages, and we'll look into various examples of manufacturing setup as well. So starting first with what do we mean by facility layout. Layout decisions. Facility layout is the process of determining placements of department, work groups within departments, workstations, machines and stock holding pattern points within the facility. So if you look into facility layout, what are the requirements in this particular process? It talks about specification of the objectives used to evaluate the design, what type of layout it would be and what design you would have, what are the demands of the products in the market and or services, then what processing requirements you need to have, and then space requirements for the elements, and then space availability. So on the basis of this inputs, you will design what type of layout you are going to develop. So if you just wanted to say as a layman's language, what is facility layout? It could be said as planning and arranging manufacturing machinery, equipment and services for the first time in the completely new plant, or say it could be improvement in the layouts already in use in order to introduce new methods or improvements in the manufacturing facility. So if we look into basic different types of production layout, that as we have discussed in this previous chapter manufacturing process, the different types of layout formats are work centers, assembly line, manufacturing cell and project layout. And obviously the layout structure or the facility which we need to have at a work center would be different than the assembly line, and it would be different at the manufacturing cell and at the project. Now let's look one by one. Okay, before we move into different types of layout formats, let's understand what are the factors influencing facility layout first. On what basis will you say select a facility layout, or how will you plan your layout? If you talk about the first factor, very important factor which determines what type of layout it should be, is materials. So when it is said that material influences plant layout, what is meant is that there is a need to provide for the storage and movement of raw material in the plant until they are converted into finished products. So every factory should buy raw materials economically when they are available, and they should be stored properly and moved from through production centers efficiently for manual or mechanical operations or chemical processing. So it mainly depends on what type of material it is. The type of material could be solid, liquid or heavy or small, depending upon the type of material you will have a different type of layout. So then talking about a product, what type of product it is? The product layout is designed with the ultimate purpose of producing a product. The type of product, whether it is a heavy product, light product, small product, liquid. So depending upon the type of the product which is being produced, also you need to say, that's why we say material is also important part, product is also important part, and moreover the workers. It depends upon the type of the worker. The layout designer should also take into consideration the type, position and requirements of employees. If women workers are employed, the layout must be planned after keeping in mind the particular requirements, the position of employees, as well as whether they would be sitting at one place or standing at one place, or they would be moving or stationary, that also influences the layout. And moreover, the other facilities which are required by the employees also need to be taken into consideration. And the other factor which is very important is machinery, the type of machinery which is required to operate the entire plant layout. Then, so what type of machinery, whether it is need to be installed, small type of machinery which can be replaced, which can be used, a common type of goods. Then depending upon that type of industry, then the industries have been classified into four different types, that is synthetic, analytical, conditioning and extracting. When we talk about say synthetic industry is also known as assembly industry, which involves production of product by the use of various elements. It could be a chemical industry, paper industry, sugar mill industry. Then extractive industry involves a separation of one element from another element. metal form, iron ore, and then conditioning industry involves a change in the form of physical properties. Metal working industries, foundries, leather tanning, these are known as conditioning industry. Then analytical industry converts raw materials into various elements. So four different types of industries. And so depending upon the type of industry also, you are going to have a different types of layout. The location